undisputed World Heavyweight Championship James Buster Douglas looking to defend.
Pertandingan tinju kelas berat antara Buster Douglas melawan Evander Holyfield atau yang disebut dengan pertarungan The Moment of Truth atau momen kebenaran, yang digelar pada tanggal 25 Oktober tahun 1990 di Mirage di Paradise, Nevada, Amerika Serikat, di mana pertandingan ini merupakan pertandingan pertama Buster Douglas untuk mempertahankan gelar kelas berat terbantahkan miliknya, yaitu setelah mengalahkan Mike Tyson secara mengejutkan pada tanggal 11 Februari tahun 1990. Dalam pertandingan ini diumumkan bahwa Buster Douglas akan mendapat bayaran sebesar $24.075.000 yang menjadi bayaran terbesar yang pernah dibayarkan kepada satu petarung pada masa itu. Sedangkan Evander Holyfield yang menjadi penantang nomor satu pada saat itu mendapat bayaran sebesar $8.025.000 untuk pertandingan ini. Namun apa yang terjadi? Inilah yang terjadi. Buster Douglas yang datang pada pertandingan ini sebagai seorang bintang, seorang pria yang telah mengalahkan Mike Tyson yang telah menjadi mitos pada kelas berat pada masa itu, datang pada pertandingan ini dengan berat badan 246 pon dan itu 15 pon lebih berat ketika menjalani pertarungannya menghadapi Mike Tyson. Dan Evander Holyfield yang datang dengan berat badan ideal dengan bobot 208 pon atau sekitar 104 kg, berhasil mendominasi Buster Douglas yang jauh lebih lamban dan memenangkan putaran ronde pertama dan ronde kedua pada pertandingan ini.
Douglas's jab less effective, so that's a key in this first round.
Douglas much bigger, 38 pounds heavier, 5.5 inch reach advantage. We'll try to keep Holyfield on the outside so he can work his jab, left hook and right uppercut, which was so useful and effective against Mike Tyson. He'll try to keep Holyfield from getting inside where he is so effective with those short, crisp, hard punches. And Holyfield has great hand speed, tries to
putting better better combinations together so far in his first round. He seems much looser to me. And you see how he always finishes his combination off with a hook. That's something he doesn't feel Douglas does. And there is that hook. Holyfield's trying to find the range for that left hook.
Holyfield respects Douglas's skills, not overconscious of his size, and is not getting sucked in by Buster's weight problems. But he does question Douglas's intestinal fortitude, which was really illustrated against Tucker in 87.
One of the important things for Holyfield here is he's
left in the hotel after the fight. Little boxing humor there, ladies and gentlemen.
More Buster Douglas tummy jokes than anything. Big right by Holyfield. Not a huge punch, but you can see he's finding the range with that punch as well as the jab. So this first round, what Holyfield wanted very much.
Evander Holyfield dictating the tempo out of the gate. Final seconds, round one.
Great three-punch combination by Holyfield.
We head into the
boxing with him, and also don't get inside because they don't want Douglas laying on it. This is, you see it right there, and that's what I said in the first round. Whoever wins the battle of the jab early is almost sure to win this fight unless Douglas lands one of those super right hands.
And now in most cases, when there were big weight, that history repeats.
Astonishing statistic when you think about it.
Of course, Primo Carnera, 270.
What he's giving him so far. And he has negated Buster's jab at this point. That doesn't mean he will for the rest of the fight, but right now,
to get more heat, more snap.
You saw Douglas is laying, admonishes him for holding, using the uppercut. Both these boxers have a terrific uppercut, and that might be the wild card in this fight, but it's only effective from the inside. So little in the first round and a half of this bout.
He's not used to that.
He is not, yeah, that's right, it may screw his game plan up. He is not the quickest starter. In the six or seven, they think their man owns it.
Holyfield does have a monstrous right. Final 20 seconds, round two. Again, the holding and hitting. Douglas holding with the left, chopping away with the right. Come on.
Will Mills Lane start taking a point away for the whole
journey and round?
You might arrest him.
All right.
You feel yourself, champ. You got to feel yourself.
Now, every time you hit him in the belly, he's pulling up. He's pulling up. Concentrate, just move and go to that belly. Work with belly. You hit him with the right hand, come back with the left hook right into the belly. Don't stand still too long.
Kemudian di ronde ketiga, Buster Douglas yang mulai ingin bangkit mencoba untuk melepaskan sebuah pukulan kanan atas ke arah Evander Holyfield, yang dengan cepat dibalas Evander Holyfield dengan melepaskan sebuah pukulan lurus dan mengenai dagu Buster Douglas dan langsung menjatuhkan sang juara tersebut ke kanvas dengan posisi yang telentang. Kemudian ketika wasit Mills Lane melakukan penghitungannya, Buster Douglas terlihat menges-nges bibirnya dan seakan-akan tampak untuk bangkit berdiri. Biarpun sudah ditunggu-tunggu, tetapi tidak bangun juga. Hingga akhirnya wasit Mills Lane mengakhiri pertandingan ini dan memberikan kemenangan TKO kepada Evander Holyfield untuk menjadi juara kelas berat tak terbantahkan yang baru. Dan setelah pertandingan ini usai, Buster Douglas dikritik habis-habisan karena kenaikan berat badannya yang berlebihan dan penampilannya yang loyo di dalam ring. Mantan promotornya Don King menyebut penampilan Douglas memalukan dan mengatakan bahwa Buster Douglas memilih meninggalkan tinju untuk menikmati imbalan finansialnya. Namun atas kehilangan gelarnya kepada Evander Holyfield, Buster Douglas sekarang bebas dari kewajiban kontrak apapun kepada sang promotor Mr. Don King. Namun dia masih harus menyerahkan $7 juta kepada Mr. Don King, yaitu sebagai kompensasi karena tidak menjalani pertandingan ulangnya melawan Mike Tyson.
And remember I said earlier, as we look at it again, that Douglas wanted to land the uppercut. That's not the way to throw it. This fight ended because Buster Douglas made a very basic...
The official time, 1:10 of the third round. And the new undisputed heavyweight champion of the world, Evander Real Deal Holyfield.
Evander Holyfield dictating the pace from the very outset and ended it at 1:10 of the third round. And a stunned Buster Douglas.
Well, you know what? It was almost a non-performance by him.